Welcome, everyone. I'm Robert Napolitano, and welcome to Thriving Through Chaos, Conflict, and Crisis, our weekly briefing. Now, last week, I touched upon recession and what defines recession. And we went through a whole dissection of the analysis, the data that you use, and showed and illustrated that looking at the definition of recession, it's rear view mirror thinking. It's all retrospective. If you'd like a refresher to see what that briefing was about, check that out on our website at gritrust.com. And you can find all of these briefings on the website. So I'll apologize for those of you who've returned for me being redundant, because I'd like to talk to a few of you that are new and attending this. You may not know my history, but please allow me to give you a brief introduction and an objective of what we're here to do today. I'm the founding partner of Grit Partners, a boutique fund management company focused on distressed real estate and debt and opportunistic insurance. That's just a fancy way of saying that I am the recycler of the banking and insurance industries. I clean up the junk that a lot of these incompetent participants put out into the industry. I've originated, modified, and traded over $1 billion in transactions since 1998. And after the great financial crisis of 2008, I went into a Chapter 13 bankruptcy and came out at a higher net worth, winning two lawsuits against two of the too big to fail banks. But the best part of that experience was getting an inside look at how the banking and the insurance system works, with money and insurance intertwined together. And I used that experience to design an investment platform so that individuals and investors just like you can invest like banks and institutions, getting the best performance and offloading risk to someone else's balance sheet. I host these weekly briefings because I feel it's important for people to be informed, given the climate that we're in, and we're facing all this chaos, conflict, crisis in the world, and all this confusion, because that's what this creates. It creates complexity and confusion, all of this misinformation that goes on out there. Investors, we need clarity. We need to have the confidence so that we can make these informed decisions to do the one thing that we're all trying to do. And that's to protect and expand our legacy for our children and our children's children. And that's the reason why I'm here today and every Tuesday at 1 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. How do I intend to do that? As I mentioned, there's a lot of noise in the investment world creating this confusion. I and my team, we intend on cutting through all of that by bringing you facts backed by data, so we can empower you to make intelligent, informed decisions. That's what we do. But in order for us to be effective, in order for us to really put you in the best position to make these intelligent, informed decisions, it requires a different type of thinking. Because as I said, where we are in this environment, it's a different world today. And what used to work no longer works. In fact, most traditional financial advisors, they react to data and give advice. That's retrospective, as I said before. It's historical data. As we talked about last week in the recession is called and declared in this country 7 months after it's happened. Well, what good is that to us? So we need to get a preview of what's to come so that we can better forecast for ourselves the moves we need to make now. So today, the topic I want to discuss is going to be inflation and how it just gets bastardized, that word, of what inflation is, and how, you know, a lot of people use that word to create a lot of rhetoric. And honestly, inflation, not that it doesn't matter to us, but it really doesn't matter to us. There's nothing we can do about it. We can't stop inflation. What we can control is how we react to the inflation. The decisions that we make today in an inflationary environment. But in order to make these decisions, I want to just highlight some details about what inflation really is. Let me share my screen here to show you what I put together for you today. Except I don't see how I can share my screen at the moment. Let's go this way and do this. Share the screen. And there you go. That should work. All right. I believe that works. All right. So what we see here, this is a chart that I put together of the inflation rate going from the beginning of 2021 to October of 23. And we're recording this in December of 23. So this is a couple of months old. But what I really wanted to show and illustrate here is two things: the rate of inflation and the price on consumed products, as the government defines, which is a rigged number in and of itself because it doesn't actually price in everything that we pay for. But that's another story for another day. So let's say we'll acquiesce to the consumer price index being accurate. And what I want to show you here is two different stories: inflation rates coming down and CPI going up and sustaining. In fact, the latest results for the CPI came out today, and it's ticked up a little bit higher again. What does that mean? Why do we care about these things? Well, as I said before, we need to look at the investment environment from a proactive point of view. We want to see what's coming. And so here's what we're being told. Inflation is coming down, but no one talks about the CPI. And here's the difference. Let's say we're driving on a highway and I accelerate my vehicle from 0 to 85 miles an hour in, I don't know, pick a number, 5 seconds, whatever. The point of it being, there's two different things we're looking at here: the rate of acceleration versus our speed. So if I get to 85 miles an hour and I put the cruise control on, if I'm still breaking that speed limit and get pulled over by the police, do I tell them, well, officer, after I hit 85 miles an hour in acceleration, I slowed down, I took my foot off the pedal? That's what we're being told with inflation rates, that inflation rate is coming down. Well, the inflation rate is a reflection of just how fast prices go up. Doesn't talk about prices coming down. That's CPI, the rate at CPI, the prices of our products goes up at the rate of inflation. And then it stays on cruise control at that level. Two different things. So when we're told in the news and the media that inflation is coming down, who cares? What's the CPI at? What's it really costing me? How much more of my personal expenses are going up? Because that's what we're really talking about here, is how much is my personal wealth eroding based on inflation and everything that causes inflation. So we want to look at CPI and really make our decisions not based on the number of inflation. Who cares about that? We care about where CPI is and what our costs are and our expenses are. So we want to look at that number. Here is a chart put together by Statista as of October of 2023, again, 2 months old. And it shows that since February of 2020, the cost of our lifestyle, the cost of living, the cost of our everyday expenses has gone up 18.7%. I revised that today because since we got the new CPI numbers out, it came down a little bit. We're in great shape. It only went up 17.5%. You need to look at this as an additional tax that we did not vote for on our personal purses. The cost of living has gone up and we're paying an additional 17.5% to live our lives. That's what's important. Not how fast it got up there, because that is important too, but how high it's gone, and make our moves and our decisions based on that. And what's interesting even more is that here is a chart put together. Who put this together? This is a Census Bureau. Okay, another government data chart. The annual growth of income. Incomes haven't gone up to keep up with the inflation. So as we talk about all the time, there's two things, really three things we care about when we're investing. What comes into our purses, what goes out of our purses, and the production of cash flow. Well, it shows here that people are not making any more money. In fact, expenses are going up and incomes have come down. That's a problem. But as we talked about last week, we're saying, well, there's no recession. Bullshit. This is what you have to look at. Oop, let's go back there real quick. Okay. That's what we need to look at. So that's what I wanted to talk about today. It's about looking at CPI and not so much at the news and the media and what they're feeding you, okay, about it's inflation, it's inflation, it's inflation. We need to look at from a banking perspective, what the bankers look like, what the big players look at, and they look at this stuff. Are rates going to be increased or decreased? They're looking at the CPI, they're looking at incomes, and what's going on with that. That's what's most important. So, as I said, this requires making informed decisions, requires a different way of looking at things and a different way of thinking about this stuff. So I gave you hopefully some insight on how to look at inflation and CPI. And unfortunately, we're in a time where it's the first time in our nation's history since the Industrial Revolution that millennials and Gen Zers will likely be the first generation to be poorer than their parents. They will be poorer than their parents. So those of you out there that have children, and you think you're in a rigged game now, in a rigged system now, it's going to be even worse for them. Which is why it's incumbent upon you to take advantage of the opportunities today to capture their future for tomorrow, because they are not going to have the same opportunities that you have today. But the good news of all this is that we're entering in a time where we will see the greatest wealth transfer in our lifetime. Here I put together a chart where Cerulli put together this chart, actually. Cerulli is a data research firm. They anticipate that $84 trillion in wealth will transfer and take place within the next 20 years. And here's how they laid out their chart. Which means that with change comes disruption. With disruption comes inefficiencies and misalignments in the marketplace. And with those inefficiencies and misalignments comes the opportunity that's ready to be seized. And so you need these facts to be informed so that you can effectively seize these opportunities immediately as they present themselves. So think of your legacy. It's how we think of ours. We think of ours, and I'd like you to think of yours in this changing mindset. You can create and expand your legacy as a result of others' incompetence in the world. And I think we can all agree that incompetence is pervasive everywhere. So here's to your greatest days of success, which are right in front of you. I wish you all a prosperous day. I wish you all a very prosperous investing. And until next time.